Attention deficit hyperactivity disorder is one of the most common childhood disorders in the United States, and it can continue into adolescence and adulthood. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, symptoms include difficulty staying focused and paying attention, difficulty in controlling behavior, and hyperactivity. Let's look at three types of symptoms. First, we have inattention. Someone who has symptoms of inattention can be easily distracted. They may miss details or forget things, and they frequently switch from one behavior or activity to another. They can become bored with a task after only a few minutes, unless they are doing something that they really enjoy. This means they can have trouble completing or turning in homework assignments. They often lose things needed to complete a task, and they seem to not listen when spoken to. Furthermore, they may daydream, become easily confused, and even struggle to follow directions or instructions. A child who has symptoms of hyperactivity may squirm or fidget in their seat. Someone with symptoms of hyperactivity may talk nonstop. They may run around touching and playing with everything in sight. They have trouble sitting still at dinner or at school, and thus they may get in trouble from teachers as well as parents for their hyperactivity. Now let's look at impulsivity. Symptoms of impulsivity means a person may be very impatient. They may blurt out inappropriate comments or show their emotions without restraint. And they may often act out without regard for consequences. They may have difficulty waiting for things that they want, and they may interrupt people's conversations or activities. Now, as you can imagine, children experiencing a combination of these symptoms can experience great difficulty in managing their day-to-day behaviors that are necessary and needed for doing well in school or interacting with others and completing a daily routine. And not all attention deficit disorders will be exactly the same. You'll see some who are more inattentive rather than hyperactive, and some who are more impulsive rather than inattentive. In order to be diagnosed with ADHD, one must meet a set of diagnostic criteria that is comprised of a number of symptoms of this disorder. And now the causes of ADHD, or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, include a combination of genes and environmental factors. Now for a long time, people suspected that the consumption of sugar caused ADHD. However, there's no research that's provided support for that idea.